Hi, I'm Sarah, and I'm going to explain the procedure for the antibiotic resistance lab activity. Remember, we learned that because of natural selection, some bacteria can live in the presence of an antibiotic that previously may have killed them. When the antibiotic does not kill the bacteria are said to be resistant, as in the case of drug-resistant tuberculosis. In lab, we will test the effectiveness of antibiotics on three bacterial species to see which ones are resistant to any of the antibiotics. You will work with one partner to test the effects of the antibiotics on one of three bacterial species. In another class, after the bacteria have grown, you will observe your results and compare them to the results of two other teams. Let's get started. Here's a petri dish containing sterile agar, commonly referred to as an agar plate. Agar is a gelatin-like substance made from seaweed. It is moist and contains nutrients, so it is an ideal environment on which bacteria can grow. Open the petri dish only as much as necessary to avoid contaminating the agar with organisms from the air. This package contains two swabs that are sterile. They will remain sterile as long as they are in the package, so do not remove them until you're ready to use them. The swabs have cotton on one end only, so open the package on the opposite end to avoid contaminating the sterile cotton. Each group of two students will receive an agar plate with one of these three bacterial species, E. coli, B. mycoides, or S. marchesians, which are growing on the surface of the agar. Your goal is to remove a small amount of the bacteria from the agar surface with a sterile swab and spread it evenly over the surface of the agar in your sterile plate, while minimizing exposure of the agar surface to the air. As you spread the bacteria on the surface of the agar, rotate the swab to be sure the sample is being transferred from the swab. You have now made a lawn of bacteria on the surface of your agar plate. Place the used swab in an orange biohazard bag to avoid contaminating any of the lab surfaces or yourself. Label the outside bottom of the petri dish, the half which contains the agar, with a large X to divide the plate into four quadrants. If you are allergic to any of the antibiotics we are using in this activity, your partner should do the rest of the procedure. Each of these sterile petri dishes contains a different antibiotic labeled with the initials of the antibiotic: AM for ampicillin, E for erythromycin, NTE for tetracycline. A fourth petri dish contains blank discs. You will place one of each of these discs using forceps on the surface of the agar. First, sterilize the forceps using an alcohol pad. Then, open the small petri dish, remove one of the discs, and place it on the surface of the agar in the middle of one of the quadrants. In order to prevent the discs from falling off of the agar, gently press each one so that it sticks on the agar. Repeat the procedure for the other two antibiotics, sterilizing the forceps before you remove a disc each time. Finally, you will place one blank disc in the last quadrant, the same way you place an antibiotics disc. We will incubate your plate at room temperature in an upside-down position, that is to say, with the agar surface on the top. This is to prevent condensation from the lid caused by the respiration of the bacteria from raining down on the agar surface and interfering with bacterial growth. Place your initials and the initials of the bacteria on the lid of the petri dish, that is, the part without the agar. The TA will collect your plate when you have finished. You will observe the growth of the bacteria in the next class period. So, what does resistance look like? Here's an agar plate from a few days ago that was swabbed with bacteria, and then an antibiotic disc and a control disc were placed on the surface. Here you see a clear zone around one of the antibiotic discs, called the zone of inhibition. The antibiotic killed the bacterial cells that were swabbed in that area. Where the bacteria have grown up to the edge of the disc, the antibiotic was ineffective. That is to say, the bacteria were resistant to this antibiotic. When you arrive at the lab, review these procedures before you prepare your agar plate. See you next time. Don't forget to wash your hands before you leave the lab.